Good day, fellow investors. My top 10 dividend stocks and dividend philosophy. Everybody likes dividends. Some need it for the income. So this video will be about how I see dividends, how I see the best dividend strategy in the current environment, and I will disclose my top 10 dividend stocks. So stay tuned. The most important thing with dividends is that they keep coming, keep growing, and that they are very stable, thus no risks. In order to get that, you need to find companies that are stable, that have good business environments, that have safety, that have good macroeconomic and good demographic trends around them, because a growing demographic trend will give them continuous growth and the ability to pay dividends. Negative demographic trends don't work that well for dividends, and then companies start slashing dividends and then you are in trouble. So don't get excited when you see a very high dividend yield. That usually means bad things. The dividends I will discuss are between 3% and 5%, so they are pretty good for the current environment, and they are all growth dividends with various benefits. So let me immediately start with Copel, or ELP. It is a Brazilian utility, integrated utility with generation, transmission, distribution, energy trading and telecommunication, operating in the state of Paraná. Very stable company, long life, 62 years in the industry, 20 years on the New York Stock Exchange. This, even if it is in Brazil, is a stable company. What it offers is a price-earnings ratio of 5.79, a current dividend yield of 7.4%, 10-year average earnings of 1.19, statutory 50% dividend payout, so you can expect dividends in the future to be around 60 cents, thus the 7.4 yield to continue in the future. And on top of everything, you can expect growth from the company's investment program and from a reversal in Brazil. So the company invested more or less $1 billion in the last 10 years in new transmission line, new power generations, and so on. So we can expect growth that will accompany Brazil's growth. And when Brazil turns around, starts growing again, exporting even more, its currency will strengthen. So if you are an investor from around the world, you will reap the benefits of a strength of a stronger Brazilian currency. Thus, the dividend that's now 7.4% might go to 10, 11, 12%. When you add the growth the company expects to make, it can be a 15% dividend yield in the next few years on your current price. So very good investment. The second stock I want to talk about is AbbVie. It's a pharmaceutical company, price earnings ratio of 18.6, stable earnings growth and dividend growth, 26 billion in revenue. Dividends have been growing by 60% since 2013. The company has a huge pipeline of new drugs, stable sales of current drugs, thus we can expect that the dividend will remain stable, the growth will remain stable, and that the current 3.4% yield increases in the future. Pharmaceuticals, aging population, developing world is starting to buy more pharmaceuticals. So, very good trends, very good company, well positioned, you can expect higher dividends in the future. And the 3.4 yield now is not that bad. Number 3, a little bit more risky, however, there are some very stable things about EasyJet. EasyJet is a European low-cost airline company. Its price earnings ratio is 22.6 and its dividend is 3.8%. The price earnings ratio should be lower, but due to the turmoil in the UK, it's currently higher. However, it's expected to be lower again in the future. So what's good about EasyJet? The good is that EasyJet has now created a very strong position in Europe, and Europe's airports are all constrained. They cannot expand. So EasyJet has secured the lines, and now they are starting to introduce larger and larger planes. Larger planes will mean lower cost. As you can see here, they are now going for larger planes, and the benefits should come from savings on larger airplanes, and the benefit should come from Airport constraints. Most airports in Europe are constrained and cannot grow. Therefore, larger airplanes will allow EasyJet to fly more people around Europe for lower cost. Thus, a very good benefit on top of the already interesting 3.8% yield. Now, let me switch a little bit to Australia. Australia is a country which has a currency that's currently very weak. However, given the expansion in India and China, demand for mining commodities is going to grow in the future. That's a given. Thus, also the Australian currency will get stronger and will strengthen. You can see here the Australian dollar against the US dollar is still very, very weak in comparison to the situation in the last 10 years. So when that happens, when the Australian dollar starts to strengthen, your dividends coming from Australian companies will just be bigger and bigger in your domestic currency. The first company I want to discuss is Westpac Banking Corporation, traded on the New York Stock Exchange. The price earnings ratio is 14.2, dividend 5.6, and it can easily go to 10% as the Australian dollar rebounds in the future and as the Australian market grows. Westpac Banking Corporation is involved in insurance, banking and wealth management. Wealth management is expected to more than triple in the next 15 years in Australia thanks to the superannuation funds. The bank has strong balance sheet, high quality liquidity position that allows the bank to maintain its dividend and even increase it over time. If you don't like banking, I have also found an Australian utility that's very, very interesting. AusNet services electricity and gas networks in a small part of Australia. However, the dividend yield is 5.7%, price to cash flow is 8.2, enough to pay the dividend. So the dividend also growing, expected to grow even more in 2018. Thus a very stable dividend yielder, with the potential benefit of a huge dividend increase when the Australian dollar eventually recovers. And there is a big chance about for that, so I'll make a new video about it. The global population is growing, they need more food, and to make more food, you need more fertilizers. So we have Potash Corporation of Saskatchewan that brings fertilizers to the world. Now the dividend is only 2.26%, but this is a temporary yield because we are at a low point of the fertilizer cycle. There have been lots of investments, lots of new supply coming online, so it's a very difficult world situation in fertilizers. However, that's a cyclical and that's very normal. You can expect in the future much higher dividends from potash plus capital appreciation when the dividends increase. As you can see here, the dividends dividend is really minimal now in 2017 and has been almost three times higher in 2015. This is because potash market is very depressed and still very low in comparison to the past. However, crop production and potash consumption has been and will continue to grow in the future. Thus, stability and growth can be expected from potash. On top of it, it's merging with Agrium, and there are additional saving benefits that are expected, thus will give even more cash for the future dividend holder. As I expect inflation in developed countries, you need to be exposed to utilities, because those can raise their prices as there is inflation. One company that I like very much is Southern Company, current yield of 4.91%, 9 million customers in 11 US states. And you can see how the dividend has been constantly growing in the last 15 years. What would be a dividend portfolio without a REIT? And I'm looking for REITs that are exposed to very positive future trends. One of such trends is, of course, aging of the population. Therefore, the REIT is Ventas, NYSA, VTR. It's an industry-leading enterprise, diversified around senior housing, medical offices, life science, health systems, and many other things. Its metrics are much better than competitors, and it's exposed, of course, to 40% of the US GDP. A GDP share that is expected to grow as the population ages. We can expect much faster growth in the population, much richer all elderly population, and the environment is very, very positive for Ventas. In the meantime, you can enjoy a 4.5% yield, which is sustainable given the price to cash flow of 16.8. That's about 6% cash flow yield. One point, there is some money left for growth, and the trend is very, very strong and positive. 4.5 yield, very good yield to be reinvested. A company that I already mentioned is Store Capital, because you invest in a strong REIT that now has the capital backing of Berkshire and Buffett. That thus the risks are eliminated and the upside remains the nice dividend. The dividend is 5%, price to cash flow is 13.5, so there is really a lot of stability and sustainability for the dividend, which is expected to grow at 5 to 10% per year. The last company, another pharmaceutical, Teva Pharmaceuticals, extremely high price earnings ratio, but don't get confused by that, because the reason behind that is that there have been some impairments in the past. You just need to look at the cash flow, which is about 1 billion per quarter, that's $1 per share, current stock price is 35. The dividend yield is around 4.4%. Or also you can see Teva's dividend history has been constantly growing. So I hope you will find some interesting dividend ideas here. Share your comments, share your thoughts, ask questions. Let's create a community here where we all learn together to increase our profits and lower our risks. I'll see you in the next video.